another chapter of Lunchbox Sai Center's online satsang. Thank you all for being with us once again. As we prepare for devotion, let's all sit comfortably. Let's close our eyes. Let's take a deep breath and remind ourselves that within each and every one of us is that flame of divine love. Let us be reminded that this flame of love is in each and everything in creation. As we do our devotion tonight, let us feel love for all of creation, and let us pray for the well-being of all.
Yeah. introduce about our segment.
Let him decide. Once, a little boy went to a grocery store with his mother. Charmed by the cute boy, the old shopkeeper took a bottle of his tastiest sweets and offered them to him.
Dear child, you can take as many sweets as you want.
But the child didn't take any. He just looked up with a wishful expression on his face. The shopkeeper was a little surprised. He wondered why the little one did not take any sweets.
Take the sweets, my dear son. It's all for you.
Come on, Uncle is giving you some sweets. Take a few.
The shopkeeper thought maybe the boy is too shy. He himself took two handfuls of sweets and gave it to the child. The boy's face lit up. He was too happy to accept them and exclaimed,
"Oh, thank you, sir."
Why didn't you take the sweets when the shopkeeper offered you? There is no need to be so shy. It's all right, sweetheart.
Mom, I wasn't being shy. You see, my hands are very small. If I take sweets from the bottle, I can only take a few. But see what happened. When the kind uncle gave the sweets with his big hands, I got so many more sweets, haven't I?
Sairam, the moral of the story is, God always blesses us with more than what we can hold. That is why it is better to trust Him to give us what we need, rather than seek things ourselves. The ocean is vast and boundless. The size of the vessel you have determines the amount of water you can carry. The vessel is your heart and the water is God's grace. We must broaden our hearts to carry more grace. Sairam.
I offer my humble pranams at the lotus feet of my beloved Guru, Bhagwan Sri Satya Sai Baba. Om Sai Ram. Our message today is the observance of Pitru Paksha, which is 14 days dedicated to the ancestors, which started Wednesday, September 2nd, and ends on Wednesday, September 16th. One of the traditions followed on the yog path is the observance of Pitru Paksha, the fortnight of the ancestors. This period of 2 weeks takes place during the Indian lunar month of Ashwin, which corresponds to the calendar months of September and October. The origin of Pitru Paksha dates back to India's oldest scriptures, the Rig Veda. It is described in the scripture as a powerful occasion on which we honor and express gratitude to those who have come before us and left for us a legacy of wisdom, of protection, of love and material wealth. By Vedic tradition, ancestors refer specifically to parents, grandparents and great-grandparents. In practice, however, people honor departed spouses, children, siblings, aunts and uncles, parents-in-law on Pitru Paksha as well. They honor friends, neighbors, teachers, mentors and even beloved animals that have left this world. For those walking the yog path, Pitru Paksha is a time to reflect on the teachings about the value of human birth, the bond that exists among all living beings, and the recognition that life is not limited to this body, and that our connection to our loved ones transcends this physical realm. We learn from the gurus that when the body ceases its activity, the eternal self, the Atma, continues to live on. In the same way, the love that existed between people lives on. Pitrupaksha gives us an opportunity to continue honoring that love and to be grateful for all we have received from our ancestors. According to the Indian scriptures, it is the dharma or the duty of those who are living to offer their prayers and blessing and the fruits of their spiritual practices for the benefit of those who have passed on. In this way, we continue to honor those who have passed on. We invoke their blessing and support them on their journey onwards. The observance of Pitrupaksha is a way to harmonize ourselves with the forces of nature. Those who live in this world and those who have departed from it are all part of the one vital power of supreme consciousness that underlies all of creation. Therefore, the giving and receiving of prayers and the continued fostering of goodwill brings about auspiciousness in our lives and in this world. The Vishnu Puran says that by worshipping our ancestors, we attain such boons as longevity, good health, strength, happiness, prosperity, abundant food, and access to the spiritual realm. The Vishnu Puran also states that those who, with faith, perform rituals for their ancestors, make the world more content and happy. During Pitrupaksha, we may choose to dedicate our practice of meditation, chanting, mantra repetition, and other prayers to our ancestors. Another powerful way of sending blessings to our departed loved ones is dedicating to them the recitation of the Sri Bhagavad Gita. Another traditional observance during Pitrupaksha is performing charitable works on behalf of our ancestors, especially donating food and giving access to support the education of children in need. Some people may even plant a tree, which is a symbol of life, to honor our departed ones. To support people in maintaining this focus, it is traditionally recommended that people refrain from beginning any new projects or major undertakings and to travel only if it is indispensable. Reason being that we should not use this auspicious opportunity to engage in mundane activities. Instead, we should give our undivided attention in showing gratitude towards ancestors. The following prayers and verses from the Upanishads and the Srimad Bhagavad Gita invoke the presence of the Eternal Self as the undying heart of all beings. During Pitrupaksha, you may include these in the prayers you offer in homage to your loved ones who have left this world. Srimad Bhagavad Gita, chapter 2, verse 20. The Supreme Self is not born, nor does it ever die. Having once existed, it never ceased to exist. The Supreme Self is unborn, eternal, changeless, and ancient. It does not die when the body dies. And from the Upanishads, Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnata Purnamudachate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om, that is perfect. This is perfect. From the perfect springs the perfect. If the perfect is taken from the perfect remains. Om, peace, peace, peace. Om Sri Sai Ram. Thank you.
Buddha Mahavira Yeshu Sai
Buddha Mahavira Yeshu Sai
Buddha Mahavira Yeshu Sai
Buddha Mahavira Yeshu Sai
Vahe
Those around you. Thank you again for joining with us, Sairam.